Morning students, now we are in grammar class, English grammar class, where we have started the chapter 13, that is present tense and past tense. In that chapter, already this present tense portion have finished. Now it's time to discuss about past tense. So chapter 13, present tense and past tense, today's subtopic is concept of past tense. So on the board already some of the sentences I have written. So first I am telling those sentences, what are those? Like Roma played tennis last night. I am underlining this, played. Yesterday I bought new clothes. This is verb, bought. Mother washed all clothes yesterday. What is the verb here? Washed. So can you notice the portions? What we have done earlier, they are the verbs have we used. These form of verbs are little bit different from there. So these forms of verb is actually the forms of verb changed to past tense, like played, bought, washed. So what is past tense? In grammar, the past tense is a verb form we use to talk about things that had happened sometime before in the past or had happened in the past. That means which have we already done. If we just tell those things which have done in the past or which have earlier done, those things we just tell to change the form of verb and to change is like that way, like played, bought, washed and so many. So these are the forms of verbs that we have changed it to the past forms. And what are the rules to change those things in a past form?
Generally, in most of the time, to change the verb form to past tense form, we just add D or ED with the verb. See some of the examples I have written there already. So let's check what are those. If the verb is ask, in the past tense form or past form of that verb will be asked. That means ED, I have underlined ED, ED has added there. In most of the cases this is common. Normally we add D or ED to change it in the past tense form. Then call, called, C-A-L-L, C-A-L-L-E-D, called. Then raise, R-A-I-S-E, raise, R-A-I-S-E-D, raised, ED has D here added because already E is there, R-A-I-S-E, raise. Already because of E is there, that's why I add D there to make it as a past tense. R-A, praise, P-R-A-I-S-E, praise, P-R-A-I-S-E-D. E is already there, that's why D has added with the main form of verb. Other exceptions also there. What are those? Now we will learn that. Now all verbs do not change into their past tense form by adding D or ED as I have said earlier. But some of the verbs take a special form. You have to be just specified that take a special form when they are used in the past tense. They are called irregular verb. What are they called? Irregular verb. Like that way, some of the examples again I have given in your book, so many are there. You have to go through this and learn those. Like present tense, if it is bring, past form will be brought. See, no rule has followed here. If it is become, in the past form it will be became. So only one way to learn this or memorize this, you have to read the things again and again. Otherwise, there is no other option to learn and understand these things. Because no rule is following here. Build, the spelling is totally changed. Built, B-U-I-L-T. Choose, C-H-O-O-S-E, C-H-O-S-E, chose. K-E-E-P, keep, K-E-P-T, kept. In your book, so many others have also given to present into past. So, learn these things again and again to memorize these forms of verbs. Some are there where it is as same as in past form. As it is in present form, same way we use in past form.
What are those? Now we are going to learn those verbs.
Some verbs are there still which are never changed in past forms. They always remain same as in present form or past participle form. What are those? Let's see. I have given some example, but so many are there same that manner. So present form like that way bet, past form again bet, same. Cut, C-U-T, C-U-T. Cost, present form cost, past form C-O-S-T. Put, put. Let, let. Quit, same way past form it will be quit. Shut, in past form it will be also shut.
Now children, I hope you have understood chapter 13, present tense and past tense. Now it is your time. What you have to do? First you have to read the chapter several times, learn the things. You repeatedly watch the videos and understand the things. Next things, what you have to do when you read any story books or your reader book, try to find out the verbs and underline those, which kind of, that means these are, what if the form has changed? Is this regular verb or irregular verb? Then if you more practice these things, more time, these things will be in a easier manner, will be memorized to you. Very soon I am going to send to you the study material. Practice the study materials and learn these things in a very well way manner. Very soon we meet to the next video class. Until then, bye bye.